Good morning, all of you. In the previous class, we have discussed about the types of attributes. So there are two types of attributes. One is synthesized attribute and second one is the inherited attributes. So both are different, and these two attributes mainly we are concentrating on how to draw a annotated parse tree for a particular string to a given grammar. So in this case, the main difference between the parse tree and the annotated parse tree means, so the parse tree means it is a tree having some nodes, whereas in the annotated parse tree means each and every node having some value. So we have to, first we have to compute the node values. So each and every node having some values, that one we can call it as a annotated parse tree. And the next topic is the evolution orders for SDD, syntax directed definition. So it is an evolution process. So in this case, so how to evaluate, the order of the attributes means, so in this case we are using the concept is dependency graph. So by using the dependency graph, we are using this one, we can determine the evolution order for the attributes. So it is a very, very important question, dependency graph. So what is the purpose of the dependency graph means? To determining an evolution order for the attributes. Next one, so all of you know that in annotated parse tree, each and every node having some values. So how to get those values? So what is the procedure? And how to calculate that values in a particular node? That one will come into the dependency graph. So while an annotated parse tree shows the values of the attributes, so a dependency graph helps us to determine how those values can be computed. Okay? So we have covered two attributes. One is synthesizer attribute, second one is the inherited attribute. So what is the procedure we have to follow to compute the particular node values? And next one, and also in this dependency graph, we have to learn two special classes. One is S attributed and second one is the L attributed, syntax directed definitions. And also in the translation process, we have to use at least one class, either S attributed or the L attributed. So in the evolution order for SDD, we have to learn these are the points. So one is the dependency graph, what is meant by the dependency graph, and the ordering, the evolution of attributes, what is meant by S attributed, and second one is the L attributed. Next one, the semantic rules with controlled side effects. So first, in this class, first I'm going to explain you what is meant by dependency graph. So I already mentioned that the main purpose of the dependency graph is to calculate or how to evaluate the node values. So a dependency graph, the flows of information among the attributes. See, connect from one attribute to another attribute. So here the edges express constraints implied by the semantic rules. See, the main purpose is The main purpose of the dependency graph or a useful tool for determining the evolution order for the attribute instances in a given parse tree. So some of the points are there. Suppose if it is a synthesized attribute, then how to compute the node values? Suppose if it is an inherited attribute, then how to compute the node values? Okay, I will explain with one example. I have already mentioned that in the synthesized attribute means we are taking the children of N and N itself, and the second one is the inherited attribute. we are concentrating on the parent, sibling and N itself. These are the main points. These are the main difference between the synthesized attribute and the inherited attributes. Now this is the one of the example. Consider the grammar. So here this is the given grammar. It is a context-free grammar. The grammar contains only one production. That is E2E plus T. And this is a semantic rule, semantic action. So in this case we are using the attribute is value attribute, val attribute. And also it is a synthesized attribute. We can say that it is a synthesized attribute. Suppose here the grammar is E2E plus T. Then the semantic rule is E dot val equal to E1 dot val plus T dot value. Now, suppose there are some string. So dependency graph. I want to draw the dependency graph. Suppose first write the parse string. Suppose here the node is E. Here the node is E. And E derives E plus T. So you can write E derives E plus T. E derives E plus T. So this is a parse tree. Suppose how to get this value? How to get this value? E value by using these three values, by using these three. Anyway, plus is a operator, but by using these two, E and T. So first you have to compute this value, this node value. After that, we have to compute this node value. Then only we can perform this value. So this value means E dot value equal to E1 dot value plus T dot value. So how to compute this one means by using these two values. Suppose this value E dot, what is the value for this one? Next one, what is the value for this node? Then only we can calculate this value. Okay? See the graph. So here the dotted lines represents. See here the dotted lines represents the parse tree. Okay, and the solid lines represents the dependency graph. So first you have to draw the normal parse tree, and then you have to give the solid lines. What is the evaluation procedure? First, which node will be executed? Next, which one like that? So in this case, starts with here only. So this value moving to the top. Again, this value, first we have to compute this value. Next one moving to the top. And then only we can compute this value. So this value depends on this one and this one. So this is the dependency graph in this example. Same way, if you take any synthesizer attributes, the dependency graph is like this because it is a bottom-up approach. Starts with the leaf node and moves towards to the starting symbol of the grammar. So this is a dependency graph. Okay? And one more example. So this is the inherited attribute. Second example is inherited attribute. It is somewhat difficult and somewhat confused when compared to the first attribute, that is synthesizer attribute. When compared to this one, synthesizer attribute is very easy. It is somewhat difficult to understand the concept. So first one. Now I want to draw the dependency graph for this one, for this inherited production. So this is the grammar and these are the semantic rules, and all of you know that this is the annotated parse tree. Annotated parse tree. Okay. For the statement is 3 star 5. Okay, 3 star 5. So first, write the normal parse tree. Normal parse tree. Normal parse tree means T. So T2. F T dash T dash. Next one, F two digit. F two digit. So here T dash means star F T dash. Next one, F means digit. So 3 star 5, same diagram. This is same diagram. But now I want to draw the dependency graph. Dependency graph means nothing but how to calculate the node values. How to calculate the node values? What is the procedure? What is the procedure? So here starts with this one digit. What is the digit? So here the lex value is. Take 3. Next value is take 3. So first this value is 3. Next one, we have to compute this node. What is this node? F dot val. So here F dot val equal to 3 because this is the value. How to get this value means it depends on the children. So this 3 copy to this one. Okay, this is the approach. Next one, in this node T dash we have to compute two values. One is inherited, second one is the synthesis. So first we have to compute the inheritance value. So how to get the inheritance value? How to get the inheritance value? Just same sibling, this one, this node value, sibling value. So 3 3, this is the inheritance value. Okay. Next one, this node. Now we have to compute this node. Again, in this node also we have to compute both inheritance inherited as well as the synthesizer. So first we have to compute the inheritance value. Before that, first we have to compute what is this node. What is this node? So here the lex value is 5. So what is this value? 5, because it copy from this one to this one, this node to this one. Next one, here how to get this inheritance value? How to get this inheritance value? Inheritance into F dot value. So here the inheritance value is 3 into 5, 15. So here the inheritance value is 15. Inheritance value is 15. How to get this means? This 3. Next one, this one. So 3 into 5. 3 into 5. 15. Okay. Now the inheritance part is over. Now this is the epsilon. T dash to epsilon. Next one. In this node, we have to compute one more attribute. That is synthesizer attribute. So here the synthesizer attribute means simply write whatever the inheritance value, it is simply copied into this synthesizer value. So that is 15. Next one, here the synthesizer value means this one, simply copied 15. Next one, this value is nothing but from bottom to top, that is 15. So this is the dependency graph. That means starts with here. Starts with here. Next one, calculate the inheritance value. Next one starts here and then calculate this inheritance value, this 3 into 5, 15, and then this inheritance value is copied into this synthesis value, synthesized value. next one, the synthesized value is copied into this one, the synthesized value. Next one, this is synthesized value is copied into big dog value. So this is the approach. This is the approach. So this is the dependency graph for the for the particular, the string is 3*5. Particular string is 3*5. So in this way we have, in this way we have draw the dependency graph for both synthesized and inherited attributes. In examination point of view, this one is very important. The previous question paper, they asked about the same example.